Alright. So, quick information for the YouTube guys that are seeing this. This is now the morning cup of the day at 11 a.m. CST, playing with Loist now. And yeah, the map is already known now because this is the third cup of the day already, but I haven't played yesterday in the evening, so this is kinda new for me. But I played it like for 15 minutes now. So, let's see. And Marius is here as well, Bock.
You're live?
No, but I'm recording.
Ah.
Because I couldn't be there yesterday.
Yo, I decided also now to wait 24 hours with my uploads. By the way.
Good decision. Although Twitch really doesn't care.
Is that something you also have to do as an affiliate?
Yes.
Yeah, it's also an affiliate rule.
The thing is that like nobody cares about that on, like, I don't know, they're not very strict.
I mean, for a long time I didn't even know about, and I also, it's not like that I did that decision now because I got now any comments that made trouble, but I thought, yeah, let's just follow the rule, it's also more fair to me.
Yeah, I also didn't know it until I got a comment on YouTube.
Yeah, exactly. And I also had a comment lately, just asking comment, but I just follow it now.
Right, should be safe.
This stream also, yeah, genau.
If everyone does it, it's basically the same as normal.
Yeah. Yeah, the thing is that people, of course, oh god, why do I have to sign up in Ubisoft Connect? No, I don't know.
Yeah, I also had to do that. No. I needed to know what my username is. Or was it email? I was struggling.
Make shortly black, guys. If I enter here my email address or whatever. Yeah, I don't know what my... Ach no, I changed that lately. Yeah, I changed it lately. So I always had the wrong. Is that correct? Something's wrong. Nice.
This map is quite easy though. Like, at least there's not a lot of parts where you can, like, actually gain something. Not a lot at least.
Well, the dirt also not that easy. In Worms at least.
Yeah, okay. Also, the start is maybe a bit tricky with the grass. Like with the gear and that you don't have airtime. Other than that.
And a lot of people also paid the end. That should be easier.
Oh really?
Yeah.
I mean, if you at least don't go for the steering trick, it's easy. I don't think like doing the smooth steer there actually saves a lot.
Constantly pressing second respawn accidentally. Gotta get up. Yeah.
I did something with replay editor and get my car skill. I am just opening a very short replay.
Yeah.
Just the start and finish. Yeah, this. Now I have my class. Okay. But yeah, also meant that basically people ask themselves maybe why Granati evades, no? And then they might think, yeah, why does Marius upload this? And then they get so weird. So it's a bit obvious.
I mean, some people probably think that it's like only for partners.
Yeah, some people thought that also, like, for instance.
But only if you're like not even affiliated, that doesn't matter. I mean, pretty much everyone is affiliated. Like, getting affiliated is not that hard on Twitch.
How does it work with streams where you stream on Twitch and YouTube simultaneously?
That's not allowed, I think. Like as soon as you're affiliate, that's not allowed. Oh, is it as affiliate? I don't know, but as a partner, you definitely are not allowed to do that.
Is there such a rule?
Yeah.
Did you see something like that? I mean, that rule with these 24 hours was written so weirdly.
Yeah, it's because like Twitch wants to have unique content.
Yeah, but how they wrote that rule, it is so difficult to read.
Yeah, true, it's a bit weird.
And they, like, they were saying a few things multiple times, I had the feeling.
It's been weird in the morning couple of the days. I drive like once at a time and then I cannot improve anymore. Like, for those 15 minutes are like so long.
Yeah. I would say maximum 10 minutes.
Yeah, would be good.
Yeah, I don't know about this one. I don't think I can get much better than yesterday in the vehicle over there.
I played the night one actually. I didn't plan to be awake there. But when it was 2:30, I couldn't go into bed. Like, when the cover of the day is so close.
But after the cover of the day, the Super Boy is also so close.
Yeah, and then someone asked me if I joined with him. And I was like, I want to go into bed. And then everyone in my Twitch chat told me that he's a troll. That he asks all the streamers. He's actually not too bad, but in that moment when you go into the Royale match, he then says, oh, my game suddenly crashes all the time. It's in the health or something. I don't know. But when Geotriac says that, then I think I can trust.
Yes.
Yeah. Why would you do that? The opposite of fun.
Yeah, some people are just stupid.
I mean, I would still maybe play once with him. And then he can show if he's really troll.
I mean, luckily it's not like GG instantly if you are playing Royal alone. That's us. There's like no banning function, like for example as in CSGO, is there? Like when you leave Royal matches, that you need to wait until you can start another one or something like this?
It was something, I think. At least in matchmaking.
Yeah, there should be something. I mean, otherwise, they would just keep doing it. I cannot improve.
The night cup of the day was a bit unfortunate for me in the end, because I got that amazing 4th place. Mm. And I got also 11th in the time sink. It was so... Yeah. And as usual, we had Elkon there. And he was dominating completely, even broke the world records during the knockout. Mm-hmm. 0.13, I think it was. Not sure if it's still world record.
Yeah, it is. And it's there's also 0.14, another 0.14, 0.15 or something like that.
Yeah, it's super close there. Oh, PB. Yay, 38. Solid.
How can you learn this so fast? When did you start driving this map?
20 minutes before the cup. Otherwise, I would not be so fast already. But before I went into the cup, I only had a 0.77. I mean, there's not a lot to learn here, to be honest, because it's just about executing it. I just yoinked Elkon his replay and then I knew everything.
Ben is there. 79, yes. Apparently. But I improved that probably.
Yeah, he's gonna do 0.1 in the knockout, the 0.2 at least. Roa also seems good. Razi is also always playing in the morning.
Yeah, Poli is also always playing. Poli is really always there.
Yeah, he also played that one time where I was playing as well.
Is Thomas Shaw there? Because he played last 3 cup of the days, all of them, and he was always in the final. It was yesterday in the evening in the final, but he was also in the night one in the final, and he was in the morning yesterday also in the final.
Yeah, Yeah, I think also, I've seen him. Or, no, I've only saw him in the leaderboard. I don't think he's playing the cup actually.
Yesterday he didn't.
Oh, another mob champion.
I've also seen always those DNF guys. Verlegen, Monkey, and
sure. I find that last dirt turn kinda hard. Where you go like left into the checkpoint. I crash there so often. I don't even know why. It's like hard to judge.
Yeah, everyone crashes there often. Thanks to multiple times in the
practice. And still survived until the end.
Also, I'm so hungry.
Until he went out with it.
Yeah. I mean, that's
I woke up at 6:50 today because of my XM and haven't eaten anything since. So hungry.
The XM is over?
Yeah, yeah, I had from 9 to 10.
Only 1 hour.
Yeah. But it was like the actual subject, the module, was like consisting of two XMs. And that one was 1 hour and then I had another one hour and they both get put together kind of. But only if you like an average have like at least 4.0, then you pass.
Yeah, I had something similar like that already. As well. But for one of them I had with the one subject I had to do like a project and then presentation, and the other one was an exam.
Hmm.
So if you pay one of them, it would be unlucky.
Yeah, the good thing is, if I have like 3.0 on one of them, which is not too hard, then I'm already safe with the other one.
Yeah.
Because we only need like 40% to pass, not a lot.
Yeah, no stricter rules.
But for those of you wondering on YouTube, the map is pretty good. At least if you ask me. I like a few no slides, some slides, like a normal mix map, I would say. And it's built by Anusado. Old Black Pearl.
Yeah, can you beat that, by the way, in top?
Barely. It's difficult. It's actually hard to read.
Yeah, all the guys yesterday with their dark monitors couldn't read it. But we could.
Obviously 11 star. But with a much worse time than yesterday.
Hey, only for 19?
What time did you have yesterday? Or now?
Yeah, I had a 0.52.
Oh.
I was still 11.
Crazy.
I don't like it that you can have skid marks after you exit the first grass.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I find not that good on this map. But it's not too big of an issue, like. Just a small, like, which takes quite long for me, then it's safe.
I think yesterday with the 11th place in time tech was, I was 9th with a 0.52 for basically over 10 minutes, it felt like. And the 10th place was down and he had a 0.62, so he was a whole 10th behind me. And nothing changed. He was always 10th, I was always 9th, nothing changed. And 1 minute before the end, someone improved and I fell down from 9th to 10th. But still, I mean, down was the 10th behind me, so there was still a 10th gap. And we had basically the whole time attack almost over. And in the last second, someone actually went ahead. It was not down, it was someone else, but how? how likely was that? Now I could maybe Valarken. Beat him, but finally get the one through. I could be on the other side.
Grass uphill is actually scary at the start.
It is, yep.
Like with the air time and gear. Yeah. 5 to 50 minutes are so unnecessary long. I mean, are there like actually some people playing that haven't seen the map before? Maybe like very few.
Yeah, Gwen.
But even if you played like 10 minutes before only. Yeah, Gwen. But Gwen doesn't count.
I mean, if you don't play it before, it's your fault. So.
Yeah, I mean, maybe people don't have time, but still. Like 50 minutes is a bit too much.
You still always, like, 5 minutes before the day actually starts here on the server, probably. So, and then you play the map.
But I think the idea you had, like last time when I was here, you said like 10 minutes time attack and only divisions of 32 players. That would be good.
Yeah.
But also not take that long then. Because now the skill difference is probably insanely big again.
One guy in the chat just literally said, in my opinion, time attack should be 10 minutes long. Like exactly as you said it as well.
And Gwen got 28.
Oh, last rank boy is 0.53.
And there's Marius. Talia Boy changes
and Van Laken out of the top.
I got sniped by Gwen, man. Of course, Gwen's doing point 2.
Please,
without knowing the map.
But yeah, what I wanted to say, so Elkon was there and he was dominating. But obviously, Elkon also had the bad rounds. And obviously, he was always surviving. In the top 5, for example, I had it should have been close rounds now, but then it was a complete garbage round. I was actually in second place, I had a good round, only Thomas Shaw was ahead, and then I even could take the safe pin because the last guy crashed. And in the end, Thomas Shaw won, and the second place was like 6 to 7 tenths behind. I was then with the safe finish 1.4 behind, and Elkon was 2.6 behind and survived because the last one was over 4 seconds behind. And then came the top 4 round, where of course all the 3 opponents survived. And in that moment, when I went out to top 3, the one guy beside Elkon and Thomas Shaw instant crashed near the start and instant DNF'd. I like to see it, no? And in the final, Thomas Shaw crashed and Elkon won. That's so typical.
I hate it when people instantly DNF.
Yeah, especially right after you go out. It's as if they don't care. And by the way, Elkon crashed after he DNF'd. Forgot to say that.
Obviously. Yeah, Elkon is slowly getting one of the lucky guys at Truck of the Day as well.
Slowly.
I mean, he was kinda lucky at the full speed dirt as well. Final, his opponent had a bad round. Slight B there.
Yeah.
Okay, it's not lucky though, but it's like kinda close.
Instant DNF. I just uploaded a video to YouTube, a short one, from the cover of today on that Banano map, on that weird map. There I was having these troubles with that first part where I landed on my roof. And I survived that one round with 16 seconds of turtling on the dirt, without a CP. Uploaded that because I think it was funny to turtle 16 seconds long in a knockout and survive it. Also unsure if that was the correct decision in that moment. To just keep turtling and not respawning, getting fast into the CP.
But also was kinda...
Because I had to turtle a whole 360.
I'm quickly gonna get myself something to
drink. But also was kinda interesting, like during the Banano map, a lot of people said like, oh yeah, bad map choice, how the fuck is this cup of the day? But in my YouTube comments, I asked if they liked the map, and like pretty much everyone said, oh yeah, more of that. Probably because they only watch it and don't play it.
Yeah, exactly. Spectating wise, it's of course much more fun.
I mean, playing was also fun, not gonna lie. I also like the map, but I just thought it's maybe not the best pick.
I also like the map. Just a bit unfortunate that there was, like in my case, no safe option for that part in general and nothing what you can do when you have respawn there. It was just missing something. And yeah, obviously also that penalty in the end. I mean, later in the time attack, I never got a penalty because I was a tiny bit faster and then I jumped further.
True.
But in the round where I got knocked out, I also got that penalty and my car was so nicely flat, basically. So nicely straight, but landed a bit on his back and instant.
Really. Yeah, yesterday I saw the Reddit post where Banano showed off that map like 2 months ago or something, and he called it I made a map with plastic bounces that are perfectly consistent. Or something like that. That are always consistent. Yeah, man, I see. I noticed that.
They were quite consistent, like 95% if you know how to do them. But that's like, that's not enough. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like for knockout, 95% is not that high. I mean, the start, I failed the start once where I didn't get it. But mainly, like, the ending was, like, very hard for me. But with that airbrake threat, it was also pretty easy.
Yeah, for me, the most annoying thing was in the morning cover of the day. I went out, unluckily, by, like, only 1 second when I had a big crash. Or when I didn't get that first one. The first bounce. And then they always drove so slow. You only needed a 44.2 or something in every round to survive, including the final. The final was one with a 44.2, and it was kind of close between them. And then first try afterwards, I went onto the map and instantly drove a 42.2, so instantly 2 seconds faster.
I'm surprised that you can be so fast, consistent.
Yeah, I had
I had finished.
Like, either I got that kind of time, or 1 second slower because of the last bounce, or 10 seconds slower.
Yeah, I mean, 42.2 was only thinkable for me with that very good bounce in that end. Like, with a very low one, otherwise such a low 42 was, like, impossible for me.
Yeah, of course, good start, but then decent. I had a few 0.3s and 0.4s in the cup itself, but doesn't matter, obviously.
Yeah.
But others had that as well. And then also went out.
I mean, that was a map that... such maps people always like to hunt, because it's special. And I saw that as you were getting out of the top 10 there.
Yeah, that's was surprising. I wanted to hunt it a bit, but it's just so annoying to hunt. You have the best runs possible until the end, and then it just doesn't work.
I mean, first I thought, when I did my PB, that I might be the unlucky person that goes slightly out of top 10 and ends in 11th or something. Then I was, I think it worked.
Oh my god, where's Lex?
What did you get? Like 30th or something?
I was in the 20 mid.
Yeah.
Thing.
Yeah, who actually won yesterday?
On this map here?
Yeah.
As I said, Thomas Shaw was in the final, but he lost it. Against... Shorty was third, Dexter was fourth.
Against Matt.
Against Matt. Yeah.
Matt. Wait, Matt won this?
Matt actually dominated this.
That's interesting.
He was on this, so consistent.
Yeah, I think Matt even won in the evening. In the night one, he won, I think, also the seeding. But I don't know when he went out. I actually missed a lot of things when good drivers went out. Like, there was also KB Strong, and he also must have went out, but I didn't realize.
Right, I see what you mean by the finish is failable. Like, actually hard. Like, it's scary with the water grip if you get a slide when you go for the... Oh my god. Okay, I'm gonna die there at some point. Like, completely. Like,
I was kind of scared with that end that I don't turn off the action key in the end. And now I have literally 3 times that button on my controller, so I'm not gonna miss it. I have it on X, I have it on the shoulder button, and I also have it on the D-pad.
Oh man, action keys.
Wait. That's not shoulder, but I actually have it on my thumbstick. That's right.
Why is there no Neo's light key for me? And there are action keys.
What would that key do? Like, how would it work?
I don't know. They'll figure something out.
Maybe... a key to stop steaming, like a
handbremse.
I mean, action keys are there to, like, make keyboard more viable. And with a Neo Slide key, you could make wheel more viable. Oh my god.
Oh Would my you god. Actually...
Oh my god, am I deaf? Don't tell me.
5 seconds.
I didn't find my respawn button. I went. I didn't make the jump into the water pool. I just jumped too low.
Yeah, that is also happening.
So with a Neo Slide, you turn obviously, then you go back to neutral quickly, and then turn again.
Yeah.
Would 10% steering be enough for that? So the you turn fully, and then you 10% steer, and then you turn fully again. Because that you could in theory work with super fast clicking. Oh my god, I got massive heal on that.
I'm not sure if you really have to go down to completely see.
Why am I so bad at those outside turns? Like you so actually, hard to get them.
I mean the fastest line is completely outside obviously. But you actually can also hold your gear and not be outside, I just did that.
Yeah.
Yeah, the gear is not the biggest
issue. But in the important rounds, I of course lose the gear there.
Well, I'm gonna die here so hard somewhere. I mean, in
this
theory...
This was what I also knew yesterday.
In theory, doing 0.5 is like not too difficult. But it's just...
0.79 wins. That is so
yeah,
slow.
That's not a good winning time. Like, at least not now. Maybe in the first cup of the day. I don't know what the times were. Wait, is Gwen out?
I saw that Ajax is out. Oh, Gwen is out.
Rip Franz.
Which action keys do people tend to use? There's an action key for water pools. If you water bounce there, usually action key 3. Then there is action key 4 or 5 for bobsleigh corners. Yeah, then sometimes for certain things on certain tracks, you can use something for nose slides or other stuff. Or for cuts, like on that Royale map.
But water is always like 30%, right?
I personally mostly use action key 0 when driving.
Yeah.
Yeah, but for nose slides, it's often like action key 7, action key 8, around that. Here in the nose slide in the start, I use action key 6.
Oh.
I found it.
Almost 4-4-4-4-4. Nussbot Zapfen is out. It's like so weird seeing those names in the Div 1. it's crazy.
On that map number 1 on the Spring Campaign, with a speed slide, you could in theory also use action key.
Oh no, I can't. Oh god, I think I'm out.
In theory, you could also use an action key yesterday on that full speed map, full speed dirt. I don't think it was helpful. Like then a really action key 1 or 2.
Oh, the whole map.
Yeah, it actually worked. I did action key... Which one did I use? Or was it 3? Because I have 3 bound or binded or what you say. Then I went with action key 3 through the whole track. It worked. On that map.
So who's gonna choke for me?
I will.
I still finish.
Yeah, that's what I need to rely on.
Close.
Perfect.
Yeah, wow. <well, laughs> 500.
Yeah. Well, my crash was so... Like, I in the first no slide at the turret, like, at the very last second, I got a slide and fully touched. And I had, like, no speed through the entire start. I'm surprised that I only lost 2 seconds. Like, 2.5. Better save that no slide a bit more. I want to upload a cup of the morning cup of the day where I go out as like 40.
Yeah.
And that would be kind of embarrassing.
And are you building it, obviously?
It depends how lucky the others are.
I mean, you weren't actually orange, right?
Yeah.
He was orange.
I was orange.
Because I didn't see chat messages.
I was orange by 500s. Is any of you actually streaming right now?
Mark is just, he just answered the question.
Oh.
Yeah. Oops. I'm always just going live. It's so, with these reruns of Copper Today and Royale a bit weird because I just go live for them and then I go offline again. And then they come again, the next one, I go live again. Offline.
And that's what I don't want to do. Like, I would have had to stay alive for like, yeah, till the next Copper of the Day. But I think I would have starved at that time because, as I said, I didn't eat anything yet.
Yeah, that's quite annoying. I mean, I had that Saturday sometimes where I did an ultra long stream. And that is quite annoying because you don't come to anything else. And then you have also thousands of Twitch highlights to do afterwards. When you're finally done with the streaming,
yeah,
you just need a break.
So scared of catching a slide at the ending.
That end is just... Yesterday, in the time tick, I didn't think so much about it, but in that moment when the knockout started, I knew I will die there. I was so unsure all the time. I went to that point. Basically, the whole track didn't matter because I always knew this is coming up in the end and it can change everything.
Yeah.
And obviously I died also then. I got knocked out because I crashed this. It was obvious.
I was quite confident with my action key setup there. The only thing that I'm scared of is not turning the action key off in the end. Happened to me like 2 times or something, but I still always made it.
Yeah, I also never use the action key off. Always try to finish with.
Yeah, I'll set a checkpoint.
The problem with this map, I also had that yesterday, that I don't really risk that much the whole time. I just leisurely drive, you know, like nice Sunday drive, constantly high margins. I can clearly see that with us being next to each other. Then when you actually need to drive fast, then it gets suddenly weird. I added that yesterday. Like in theory, like when it got to like top 10 and then in the top 8 round, I could have driven faster. I didn't need to drive faster, but I could have driven faster. I wanted to drive faster, but it's just so weird at that point. Not in the flow.
I think that's fine. Suddenly you try to focus on what you're doing. And
yeah.
Before you were just not thinking about it, sometimes that's better.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, now also the first rounds in this knockout, I didn't even try this in this knockout. I didn't think about that it's knockout. The further we come, the more I think about it. Then I suddenly start losing my game.
Oh, it's raining outside for me.
Oh. Oh, it's raining for you?
Yeah. Probably getting wet.
How was that for the quiet?
I barely made it into the finish. Yeah, for me it's sunshine outside. I thought about jogging, but...
It's like the middle. Like still kind of white, but like a lot of clouds.
I also wanted to go jogging today, but I guess if it's raining, it's not that good. Yeah, last time I was jogging, I went a new route and like I extra checked when was it last time it rained. It was like over 1 day ago. It was mostly fine. All the routes were really nice, but then one route was terrible. It was complete, like basically mud everywhere. It was like water puddles everywhere and blocking the whole route as well. And I was already like 1 kilometer into the way.
Sorry.
I couldn't turn back. That was really bad. And that was also the first time I used new running shoes, so they were now instantly super dirty.
Did you use action key over the water bottles?
or not.
Oh.
Are you? Oh, am
what
I?
Is this round now?
Wow.
Wait, you could have been in though.
You go up in the ranking, but not down.
Yeah, I did the deck. I hit that check. I don't know how I hit that checkpoint. That doesn't make sense. I was.
Just right when I made a choke, man.
Like I was in the middle, I was full steering and I still hit the checkpoint. Like usually I miss it by like a meter or something.
I actually made myself a lot of thoughts about how I want to do the rhythm now for my days, depending on if I work or if I don't work. And that when I'm not working and the weather is good, then I would always do some sports in the morning. But yeah, first day now, I failed miserably. My plan was that I go early into bed. I ended up playing the night cup of the day instead. My plan is nice. To stand up at around 9 a.m. and to do breakfast and sports than before this cup of the day, but I just got awake. So I have to do it afterwards. I think it's a bit switched. But from tomorrow on, when I'm working, I have, of course, kind of rhythm, because I then have to be there. Let's see. Also with the eating.
Oh, the leg, what the fuck?
Maybe not eat always after the evening stream, right before I go sleeping, but before the cup of the day. Which only works, however, if I don't work. So if I'm working, I try to eat dinner at work.
I'm having really bad legs at the moment. But I'm still alive. What the fuck? Can I, like, stop? I don't know if you see that in the recording, but what on earth? Like, not too helpful to drive.
The recording, you see it much better. Sometimes when I have these internet lags. Sometimes when I have these internet lags, you see in the stream only a big freeze. But I see all these funny things that my car is beaming to somewhere.
Yeah.
And nobody can see that. In the recording, you can see exactly what happens. That's an advantage.
Marius, I'm just testing the new Royal map right now, and this seems like the worst map ever. Really boring.
I didn't see it yet. It's good that they do it.
It just waits.
Donati, you play Royal with us.
Hmm?
Yup.
You play Royal with us.
I haven't played Royal in a while, actually.
Yeah.
I don't know any of the new maps.
Yeah. I know.
I mean, after a cup of the day, I need to take a break first, because as I said, I haven't eaten anything.
Yeah.
Oh, you have 15 minutes.
Fantastic. How long does that take, though?
30 to 40. Depends if you qualify. Just always, obviously.
Oh, Roa's out. Interesting. It was the strongest opponent, I think.
He often goes out. He's often fast in the morning kills.
Yeah, it's so that that morning KO that I was talking about earlier on that random plastic bounce map where the winning time in the final was only a 44.2. That was Roa.
Oh.
So Marius, this Royal map is literally just driving straights and surviving. It's very easy though to survive. So this is probably a lot of respawn abuse. Like the biggest respawn abuse map ever, probably.
But I can definitely tell that this morning cup of the day is again much easier than the night one. How you could reach top 7 here, top 8.
Well, what did you need?
Nothing.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Nothing strong.
I mean, I was surprised that I was out with only 2 seconds, or that I would have been out with only 2 seconds behind.
But I jinxed myself a little bit. Now I'm driving in red after a not so perfect start.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Thanks, Sapi! Sapi, fucking legend!
Oh.
Oh my god, Sapi, I love you! I completely died!
Well, I'm third!
But he deserves not it so much! He deserves it so fucking much! He deserves it so fucking much. Never retire. He deserves it so much being out.
Ach, you're so lucky.
You should have seen what happened.
But like, you were not the only one. I mean, there was also someone else suddenly 4 or 5 seconds behind.
Yeah. Oh my
and God. I got up to third. I was in red the whole round.
Oh, that's a bad story. Oh, no. Gear down mania. Oh no, I might be out. Like 25 grand, fuck. Ah, please don't overtake me. Please, 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 please. Oh. Oh, hello, Marius. Oh, no, but what happened last round? Like, after the last story turned to the left, I clipped the checkpoint at the right and fully choked. That was really bad. And now I got, like, all the gear-ons at the start, instantly lost half a second.
Yeah, oh!
Okay, so, yeah. I was driving so well on autopilot, and now it's, like, giga. Oh no. Alright. Nah, I'm out. Oh, it might have looked stupid. I slipped off my brake key and that's why I got a nose slide. Yeah, I'm out. Oh my god, what am I doing? Oh my god, that guy even choked as well. But he's further behind. I'm further. I slipped off my brake key! Ah, oh, you gotta be kidding me. No.
Basi and Roli, two big
fuck,
opponents
man.
In the morning.
What were those last 3 rounds? They all were garbage. No. Alright, go. Oh, somebody got a slowdown. Basi, he clipped the ramp.
He can still catch up.
Yeah, but it's he also has bad gear. It's like 0.8. Well, 1 second actually. Okay, one guy choked. You can full save. Oh my god, Razi survives. Oh, oh my god. Yeah, full save. 1.5 seconds. Okay, he retired.
You mean tires?
No, yeah. No! After like this round? Yeah. To be honest, I was lucky. But still.
Has there been any good round yet where you go out with like a 45?
Yeah,
no.
Yeah, the one before.
Yeah, but also not really.
not really too good, but.
Yeah. Ask for 45 low. Or 45, let's say
no.
45.
No, well, no then.
That's
pretty... Kega, man. Yeah, the map is definitely good for those of you on YouTube. I like
Now I need a very good run. So now
it will be close. Alright, go focus.
Need to try this if it was time attacks even.
Close. A bit behind point one. Oh, they both got good apples. We need to pull a risk. Like point three almost. Yeah, rip. Yeah, but they have a really good round.
Yeah,
they had really good starts.
That they were doing good now.
Yeah, they both do like 0.5, I think. Or something. Yeah, good guess.
Yeah. My PB, I struggled so long in the seating, 15 minutes to reach a 53, so.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
Yeah, that was the first good round, though.
But then they knocked it out of the park.
Now somebody's gonna die.
I basically needed that Rasi is not surviving the last round. No? So that I have the other opponent, because the other one was definitely beatable. Okay, Poli versus Rasi. Poli is also reaching the finals a lot.
Okay. Both good starts, probably a bit more speed. Rasi has to lift off a bit, but you actually overtook. Now the dirt apple is gonna be important. Oh, and GG.
Rasi crashes.
Didn't actually lose that much because he knows that the exit, but usually it should be safe.
But 2 days ago I lost the final against Brody. I could have won it, but he's doing good. He's always there in the second and third cup of the day.
And he makes it a GG. Bad time though. not a good time. But I guess he saved a bit, so it's fine. Oh yo, GG. Yeah, the level is definitely a lot lower than in the main cup of the day.
Yeah, it's also for a long time lower than the Division 2 would be. But
yeah, true.
The last rounds can be then, however, Div 1 level.
Yeah,
depends on if the good players survive, but they are of course faster than in the real Div 1.
If you just go like maps wise, you have like divisions 1 to 6 or 8 in Division 1, kind of. If you compare it with a normal cup of the day.
The field is just more spread. The highs are higher, the lows are much lower.
Exactly. No, the highs are the same though.
No, it's fire. Well, okay,
yeah, okay, a bit. But the lows are definitely a lot lower.
Like, usually, it's much the top times are much faster. But
I mean,
just look at the time attack seeding as well, the time attack seeding.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, and yesterday, top 3, we had 2 drivers try for 0.5. That did not happen.
Alright, I'm gonna end the recording now. I hope you enjoyed the cup. And, yeah, tomorrow, the regular cup of the day will be uploaded again. So, yeah, bye-bye.